as an antibody, we think in this particular crisis, this is why we chose to focus as an antibody treatment first. We're pragmatists, and an antibody works right away, like within 20 minutes of infusing. You can use it on patients. So it's exactly the problem that we have. It's the 10% of people that actually get pretty sick that go into a hospital that need treatment. 90% of people don't get that sick, and they're going to get immunity afterwards. So the virus is actually sort of its own vaccine in the population. It's really that 10% of people that are in a hospital that's the real problem. They can get an antibody right away. They won't get that sick. They'll recover. They leave. We know that this worked remarkably well for Ebola, where we went from 50% of people dying to 94% survival rate. This works remarkably well for rabies, which is a death sentence if you don't have the antibody, and it's perfectly survivable otherwise, and a variety of other application areas. So for that reason, we think this is the important thing, because as soon as your death rate and the rate of people being stuck in the hospital for like 4 weeks goes away, then suddenly this whole crisis is over, right? 90% of us are just going to be sick and be okay, or you go in, you get your boost, and you leave with the antibody. And the 10% are people who are really sick, get a boost, they don't get that sick, they survive. And we can all go back to work, and we can stop wearing these goofy masks, and we can hug our grandmothers again. So that's why we think that, and that can happen faster. We can run fast studies, so we can start releasing the drug by September, and we can rectify the global economy, which is related to our health, in addition to protecting our lives. I'm Jake. I'm the CEO and founder of Distributed Bio.
Hi, everyone. My name is Sarah. I am the director of contract research at Distributed Bio. And along with Jake, we are featured in the Netflix docuseries Pandemic. And now we are working on making a medicine to treat COVID-19. And this is also just so that you guys can spread the word on our research. We want everybody to know what we're doing. We're a small fish in a big pond, actually, here in the pharma biotech industry. We're a small company, so the more you can spread the word about our research, the better. Starting at the end of January, up until the end of March, we engineered a set of antibodies to react to and block the novel coronavirus. We have successfully completed the engineering of taking SARS neutralizing monoclonal antibodies. We have made billions of mutant variants of those in our lab, and then we have down selected those billions of variants to a couple dozen that are binding the most tightly that are adapted to the new coronavirus. And now that we have those identified, we have now characterized their interaction with the ACE2 receptor on human cells. So that's how these antibodies can block the virus from entering the human lung cells. And now we are prepping material to send off to other groups for further testing, which will be necessary for starting clinical trials. We aim to begin clinical trials at the end of the summer. So that would be around the August time point. There's a lot of things that need to fall into place and a lot of money that needs to fall into place for that to happen, but that's what we're working on right now.
The other thing we're doing is we're definitely doing the hamster protection model. I want to know that the drug protects a life form, right? Someone asked me like, hey, could you just give the drug right now? Would you take it? And my answer was like, no, I wouldn't give this drug to my mother or to myself right now, because I want to know it can save a hamster. I want to know it saves a life form. I'm a little hesitant to partner with a big pharma because I'm worried certain conditions need to be met, right? And I want to make sure this actually gets to patients, that it gets out there quickly, and it's at a reasonable price. I think if we don't achieve all three of those things, then we've failed in our mission. So here's how you can help. So first off, we think that world governments should pay for this. So please help them hear this message. So contact your representatives. If you know someone in government, please connect us. Please help us communicate, and not just the United States. Like Sarah was saying, we want to make sure that we get to the point that we have this medicine treated and tested and effective. And at that point, the world needs access to it. And that means we need to talk to multiple nation governments to make sure that the experiments we're planning and the phase trials we're planning are going to be suitable for the whole world. And if they're not, we need to start making plans now. The second thing you can do, if you have money you don't need, you can donate it at our website. So people have already been donating quite a bit over the past week, and we'll be announcing what we do with that. That would basically be, again, our position is we think government should pay for this, but as they're deciding whether to give us the grant, this money can help us support neutralization assays or the hamster studies, or bring in more people to help us network with the FDA. And we'll announce what we choose to do with that money when it shows up. And we're very appreciative of the folks who've already given. So you can go to www.centivax.com and you can donate if you want. And again, money you don't need. Spread the word. The more people that hear about this, the better. We have what we think is a very strong medicine. This can be and our goal is to get the world having access to it. And so we want your help to get it out there. The cost of goods of an antibody therapeutic is actually pretty small. It could be about $100 a dose, maybe a little bit more, $200 a dose. Traditionally, these drugs are charged at like $8,000 or $9,000 a dose, but most of that is corporate profit of very large companies that have like 50,000 employees. We're a relatively small group, and we think the cost of goods could largely be supported by governments. So we can end up creating a medicine which is efficiently priced to be able to distribute out to the world, which we think is what is needed right now. Once there's enough people in hospitals being treated, then the crisis is over because it's no longer as dangerous to get COVID-19. So people are no longer as worried about it, and they can go out and begin resuming their lives.